They've both traveled last night from Chartres, which is just to locate to the town, 80 kilometers from south of Paris. Very known for hometown of the event, which is just taking place at the moment, and Pic Assiette, but also the cathedral, which is very famous and UNESCO listed, very famous for its stained glass work, famous also for its museum of stained glass. Anyway, it's an important moment for Mosaic at the moment. But the 3R Association is famous for its very important social work in Chartres. But we wanted today to talk about Raymond Isidore, also called Pic Assiette, and Christiane is going to talk about it.
Okay.
First of all, Christiane, could you tell us a little bit more about Raymond Isidore?
Donc Raymond Isidore, ce serait bien de remettre.
Est-ce qu'on peut les avoir une par une?
Can we have them one by one?
En fait, il est né le 8 septembre 1900. Il est décédé en 64. Et cette année, nous avons fêté les 50 ans de sa mort.
So Raymond Isidore was born on the 8th of September 1900 and he died in 1964. And that was like 50 years ago, so they celebrated his death anniversary this year.
Donc, au niveau de sa famille, il était le septième enfant d'un foyer désuni, pauvre, et a eu une enfance malheureuse.
So he was really from a very disadvantaged background, seventh child in a very poor family. And he was given a very strict he was brought up in a very strict way and had a very rudimentary education.
Quand il s'est mis à travailler, il a exercé plusieurs petits boulots, je sais pas si on dit ça en Angleterre. Pour finir, ce qui était le plus important, c'était balayeur au cimetière municipal, en fait. C'est ça qu'on retiendra de son travail.
So, Raymond Isidore was someone who was not really able to keep up a job, the same job. So he's been, he's had many, many different jobs, such as working in coal, working, yes, whoa, I've lost something. Yes, he's been like a smelting plant employee. He's been working in a railway. He's been also a prop man in a theater, and his last job was like he was given the job of a cemetery municipal sweeper.
En fait, c'était quelqu'un de plutôt instable, révolté pour toute forme d'injustice, et changeait souvent d'emploi.
So he was a very unstable character, very rebellious to any form of injustice.
Par contre, dans sa vie privée, il a épousé Adrienne Roland en 1924, on ne la voit pas, Madame Isidore, la veuve d'un cheminot, et qui était son aînée de 11 ans.
So, on the opposite, in his private life, he was actually quite stable. He married Adrienne Roland, who was 11 years older than him, mother of three, and he stayed with her for the rest of his life in a very stable way. Christiane, could you tell us a little bit more about this amazing house that he created in the high quarters of Chartres?
Donc, la maison que vous voyez a été achetée par le couple hein, dans le terrain de Saint-Cheron, à deux pas du cimetière.
So they bought two plots of land in that area, which is quite disadvantaged in Chartres. Two plots of land, which is just nearby the cemetery. Là, je suis en train de parler des deux enfants qui m'ont aidé.
Aussi. Oui.
And they built up entirely this house themselves with the help of their two stepsons. And they moved in 1930. Any chance you tell us when they started to build the house? On which year did they start the house?
1930.
1930. And how many years did it...
30 ans.
It took them 30 years to finish it.
En fait, je reprends.
Ouais.
Donc, quand il a eu fini sa maison, il s'est promené dans les champs et il a vu des petits bouts de verre dans les champs et qu'il a commencé à ramasser parce que c'était joli. Et il a commencé à les amasser pour décorer la maison. Donc, il commence par. On ne voit plus le. Voilà. Il commence par la partie qui est un peu en avant.
Alors, il faut que je le vois.
Voilà, ici.
So he started the house in the front of the house, and he collected all the materials from his numerous wandering walks through the fields, through the cemetery, started to collect tons actually of materials, and he started here at the front of the house.
Je pense que je reprends là. Non. Donc, en fait, il va ramasser 15 tonnes de débris de vaisselle.
So he's going to gather 15 tons of broken crockery.
De faïence et de verre glanés un peu partout.
And, you know, from ceramic, glass, found from everywhere.
Il y consacre 29 000 heures de travail.
29,000 hours would have been needed to do that.
Et il parcourt des kilomètres avec un sac sur l'épaule à la recherche des morceaux de vaisselle, de toutes sortes d'objets. Il visite les tas d'ordures, la salle des ventes, et il travaille la nuit à la lumière d'une lampe.
So relentlessly he walks for miles with bag on his shoulder to find leftovers or all kinds of fragments of objects. He went to auction rooms, he went to household rubbish and landfill lands, and all these places were actually his favorite places. At night he would work with a little light and next to him, and he was saying as well that he would get his inspiration through his dream.
Alors, en fait, c'était un personnage souvent moqué. Mm-hmm. Donc, pendant la guerre, il a travaillé dans un entrepôt de charbon et il a eu une crise qui l'a amené dans un hôpital psychiatrique et qui donnera de lui une image de quelqu'un de perturbé.
So he was at the time, because he was doing something which was perceived as really mad, he was really mocked at a lot. And during the war he was working in a coal warehouse, and around that time he started to have a sort of a dementia episode, and he was sent to a psychiatric hospital.
À sa sortie, en fait, le seul poste qu'on lui propose, c'est celui de balayeur du cimetière. Hein. Et malgré une déchéance qu'il ressent, il accepte le poste et refusera après de changer d'emploi.
So when he came out finally of the hospital, which was in March 1949, the only job he was offered was this cemetery sweeper position, but at least it was close by from his home. At that moment he felt like it was a real failure to be offered this position, a sort of decline. And but he accepted the job and carried on until his death. Yeah, and that his psychiatric background and his sweeper job position made people feel very condescending towards him, which explains a lot the character actually. Comment Picassiette est devenu Picassiette?
Alors en fait,
Picassiette became Picassiette, yeah, because right. To pick is like to
when
to pick. Big plates, yeah.
Picasso. Sa maison, effectivement, attire de nombreux visiteurs qui sont de plus en plus nombreux. Et c'est ainsi qu'il reçoit la visite de Picasso en 54 hein, et aussi sera photographié par Doisneau en 56. Et le nom de Picassiette, Picasso, de l'assiette, hein, c'est ainsi que le nom, on peut penser que c'est à ce moment-là.
Ok. Little by little, his house started to attract more and more visitors and became rapidly the talk of the whole neighborhood. People loved coming to visit him and see how he was getting on with his work. He was not very interested by success, but nevertheless, he received the visit of Picasso himself in 1954. And he has also been photographed by a very famous French photographer called Robert Doisneau in 1956. Would that be the reason why he was called later the Picasso of the plate? We don't really know why, but that could be one of the reasons. How did he become such a multidisciplinary artist? Because he had no education whatsoever, and he demonstrated with that work that he was not only able to be an architect, he was a spontaneous architect, he was also a sculptor, he was also a landscape designer, he was an artist, mosaic artist. So how did he become this multidisciplinary artist? Comment est-ce qu'il est devenu cet artiste multidisciplinaire?
Alors comment il est devenu? En fait, en 52, il a terminé sa maison. Et ensuite, il a commencé à faire des extérieurs hein, et puis à créer effectivement des statues dans le jardin. Et puis à créer un tombeau. Donc effectivement, ça nécessitait d'être à la fois décorateur, architecte, sculpteur pour pouvoir réaliser son œuvre à l'extérieur qui fait une boucle et qui revient. Et par contre, il y a eu dans le jardin, c'est un mélange de sculptures, de peintures sur les murs et de mosaïques, mais tous les murs n'ont pas été recouverts de mosaïques ou de morceaux d'acier.
Ok, so he has, we can say, accomplished a considerably huge work of art from being the architect of the whole house. Even though he had the help of his stepsons, he created a chapel outside of his home, a huge
Popper church.
Yeah, the Popper church, yeah, as he called it, a black courtyard, also a summer outer courtyard, passages, and a huge garden. Anything to add on this one? Est-ce que vous avez d'autres choses à rajouter justement sur la construction, l'architecture?
Non, simplement peut-être parce que j'ai pas dit un mot de Madame Isidore. Hein, et c'est peut-être le moment d'en parler.
Christian would like to talk about his wife because there's the artist, but there's also the wife behind who has to accept it. So yeah, maybe it's important to talk about it. So how did she go through the transformation, major transformation of this house?
Comment
a-t-il vécu en fait,
Madame, en fait, Adrienne, elle a suivi l'idée de son mari. Elle a vécu dans la maison, elle s'est servi des objets, on la voit coudre.
So we can say that she was quite a cool lady,
huh?
Because we, if you look closely, you will see that absolutely everything in the house is mosaic. There's nothing which has not had a tile on it. So that's from the sewing machine to the cooker, to anything. Anything you can imagine is covered of mosaic.
Elle pensait que c'était un artiste.
She oui, just thought he croyait. Was an artist and let him be.
C'était la première femme. C'était la première femme.
She was his first fan. She was like really... and so how does the story carry on? Comment est-ce que l'histoire se poursuit?
Alors, en fait, dans l'évolution, comme il y avait beaucoup de visiteurs, les visiteurs laissaient une pièce à Picassiette ou à Madame Isidore qui avait une urne.
So, because it became more and more important and it was attracting more and more people, people started to leave money, like almost like a charity. Ouais.
Et donc. Effectivement, le fait qu'ils reçoivent de l'argent et qu'il y ait des visiteurs, les impôts, l'administration ont commencé à lui demander des comptes.
So little by little, the fact that people were leaving money to him started to attract the attention of the tax people, of course, and they started to create trouble.
Et, en 1962. Il y a eu un projet immobilier autour de la maison de Picassiette hein, et il fallait qu'il vende une parcelle, enfin un bout de terrain à la ville.
Ok, so in 1962, the town wanted to create a big project of building flats behind his house, but they needed a parcel of his of this plot, and so that's been really troubling him because he had been building his garden and his mosaics, and he had suddenly to concede a part of it to the town.
Et pour lui, c'était un début de. On commençait à grignoter.
Yeah, for him, it was the beginning of starting to take from him. What about the tax people? Au sujet des impôts, qu'est-ce qu'ils ont fait?
Ils lui ont imposé une billetterie.
Okay. Voilà. Et, so
il y avait des contraintes. Il n'était plus chez lui. Il était dans il y avait des chez okay. l'administration.
So the tax people actually started to organize a ticket office in his own house, and he started to feel that he was not at home anymore. He started to feel that actually everybody was starting to get inside his temple.
Et son rêve est devenu une annexe de l'administration.
Yes, and his dream became an annex of the administration.
Donc, à cette période, il commence à fuir les visiteurs.
So, at that particular time, he started to escape from everybody, visitors, tax people, of course.
Il est entré à l'hôpital psychiatrique à nouveau.
And he started to have dementia problem again, and he went back to the psychiatric hospital.
Il errait dans les champs.
People can recall of him, you know, wandering in the fields on his home and not on his own and not knowing where he was going. So he was starting to lose the plot.
Et il mourut donc le 6 septembre 1964. Et il paraît qu'on le trouva hagard au bord d'une route. Et dans un fossé où la rumeur dit qu'il aurait mangé de la terre, avalé de la terre.
Okay, so the end is not very pretty, but he started to run away from all the visitors and from everybody, and he was found on the 6th of September, dead on the in a ditch and with mud in his mouth, like almost like if he had been eating mud. So yeah, he didn't finish. Well, but to go back into positive notes, what does he say about his work? Qu'est-ce que dit Picassiette de son travail?
Alors, lors des interviews avec les journalistes, Picassiette disait qu'il j'ai construit ma maison pour y habiter.
So, at the time, actually, he had been interviewed by many journalists, and he said. I built my house first because I wanted to live in it.
La maison achevée, je me promenais dans les champs quand je vis par hasard des petits bouts de verre. J'ai trié le bon, jeté le mauvais et les ai amoncelés dans un coin de mon jardin.
Now, I built my house first because I wanted to live in. I needed a roof above my head. Once I finished my house, while I was having a walk in the fields, I saw, just by pure luck, little pieces of fragments of glass on the floor, and I picked them up, I started to sort them out, I threw the bad ones, or I piled them up on the side of my garden, and that's when suddenly I got the idea of why not use them and make mosaics on my walls.
Yeah. Au début, je n'envisageais qu'une décoration partielle et je me suis pris au jeu et voilà le résultat.
So at the beginning, I only wanted to partially cover the walls of my house, and little by little, I got hooked, and here is the result.
Il faut du beau, il faut que ce soit bien fait. On ne fait rien sans mal, mais le mal se transforme en beauté.
Okay. So, I want to create beauty, but it needs to be well done. And we don't achieve anything without any pain, but the pain is then transformed to beauty. And that was an interview in 1962 by a famous journalist called Gilles Herman.
On jette tant de choses alors qu'on pourrait en faire de la vie et du bonheur.
People throw so many things, but they could transform these things into life and happiness.
Il ne faut rien jeter sur la terre, on jette des choses, des êtres.
Nothing should be thrown away on earth. We throw things too easily, like human beings. He was probably referring to himself.
Moi-même, j'ai été un décritus. J'étais dans la misère. J'étais dans la mort, puisqu'on m'a mis au cimetière.
Me too. I have been a litter. I was living in misery. I was in death because I was sent to the cemetery. I had to get out of it. I had to save myself from death so I could meet my spirit.
Je devais sortir, me sauver de la mort, c'est ce que vous venez de dire, je crois, pour rejoindre mon esprit. On m'a mis balayeur dans un cimetière comme quelqu'un qu'on rejette parmi les morts, alors que j'ai des capacités pour faire autre chose et je l'ai prouvé.
I was given the job as a cemetery sweeper, like someone which can be sent with the dead people, whilst I had so many capacities to do something else, I had to prove it.
Je cherche l'inspiration, la création viendra ensuite. L'esprit m'a dicté ce que je devais faire pour embellir la vie. Beaucoup de gens pourraient en faire autant, mais non, ils n'osent pas.
So, I'm looking for inspiration. Creation can come later. The spirit detected me what I had to do to embellish my life, and a lot of people could do the same, but they don't even want to try. Me, at least, I took my hands and they made me happy. I wanted to be an example. So that was just a brief snapshot of who was Raymond Isidore as a person and his life achievement, which has, in fact, somehow he doesn't even know it, but he has helped so much the city of Chartres to do an enormous social work that Patrick is now going to talk about, because he's been the director of the 3R Association, which stands for, the 3Rs are to renovate, to restore, to revive. And it's an association which is located in the same area, neighborhood, of this house, which is very poor, disadvantaged, which used to be a transit city. A transit city is a city which has been built just after the war, a temporary city where we had to put people and to house people in a quite emergency way. Obviously, a few years later, it became a very, very disadvantaged city, area, with lots of crimes and violence. And this is where Patrick 25 years ago, started to do an enormous job of re-injecting employment, reviving the mosaic of Picassiette, to give an example to all the local people and to involve them in making many, many mosaics to somehow save themselves from this social agitation, as Norma said earlier on. But now I'm going to give the word to Patrick. Patrick, you are the director of the association, the 3R, so renovate, restore, and revive. How would you describe your organization?
L'entreprise 3R, quand on a créé l'entreprise 3R, on avait l'ambition d'offrir des emplois aux habitants de ce quartier, qui étaient des habitants d'un quartier ghetto.
So, our ambition was to provide jobs for the local people who were living in this neighborhood. So this is just behind the Picassiette house. À quelle date exactement?
L'ensemble a été construit en 1954.
So that was built in 1954.
Et nous avons commencé notre opération en 1989.
And we started our operation in 1989. So our ambition was to provide jobs, first of all, jobs for the local people,
Alors donc cette entreprise associative, c'est une entreprise qui aujourd'hui rayonne sur l'ensemble des quartiers de Chartres.
So it's not only in that the resonance of their work is not only now on this neighborhood, it's on all the neighborhood of Chartres.
Elle donne du travail à une centaine de personnes
chaque année. To 100 people every year.
Ils sont encadrés par une quinzaine de travailleurs sociaux.
They are guided by around 15 social workers.
La plupart de nos clients, ce sont des particuliers, mais aussi la ville.
So most of our clients are individuals.
Les bailleurs, l'office HLM.
But also the social landlord or housing council. So it's the clients.
Immobilières.
Yeah, estate agents. So it's they are working not only with the private, but they're working as well with the social and council institutions.
Et dans cette entreprise, nous faisons du ménage, de la sortie de poubelle.
So
nous faisons de l'entretien des espaces verts. Nous avons une menuiserie et nous avons bien entendu un atelier mosaïque.
So we have many, many different kind of activities. The first one which comes to mind, and it's a wink to Isidore, is like we do lots of cleaning jobs. So we have lots of people who are also sweeping the floors. We do lots of fixing. We fix anything which is from housing council flats, for example.
Ce qu'on peut dire, pourquoi finalement on a rencontré Picassiette dans cette entreprise, c'est que c'est une entreprise de balayeurs.
Yeah, it's a company which at the beginning started with cleaners, sweepers.
Et un modèle pour nous sur ce quartier, c'était évidemment le balayeur Picassiette.
And our model for us in that specific area was Picassiette, who was himself a sweeper.
Christian nous a dit qu'il était aussi un architecte spontané.
He was also a spontaneous architect.
Et on a dû effectivement, tout au début de l'association, la collectivité nous demandait de trouver des solutions pour aider à la reconstruction du quartier et associer les habitants à la reconstruction.
So, yes. So the local collectivities wanted us to improve somehow this agitated area, and For us, our model was Picasso, so we decided to use him as our model and inject mosaic and how can I say that? And involve the local people into the making of the mosaic, the designing and the making, and also to embellish their own home. That was the aim of the whole project.
Nous avons commencé en nous tournant vers les enfants et vers les écoles. Et nous avons fait faire des mosaïques, et d'abord des dessins, mais ensuite des mosaïques, aux enfants des écoles qui ont donné le coup d'envoi.
Okay. So the first stage was with the children. We worked with the children from these buildings there that you can see behind. We asked them to draw, design what were their dream mosaic they would like to see in the buildings inside. And they came up with beautiful work actually. And it was such a success that it marked the first, it marked actually the continuation of this mosaic adventure. From that moment, we started to work as well with other type of people, such as the adults this time.
Un moment fort a été la réalisation d'une première mosaïque, un peu naïve, mais importante symboliquement, qu'on a appelée le rêveur d'assiette.
So this mosaic that you see is the one of the most important work that they've done because it was the beginning of a big success. It's called the Dreamer of Plates, a mosaic which has been copied on one of Raymond Isidore's wall because Raymond Isidore is at the origin of this mosaic.
It's a copy of the same picture he has done in his own house. Yes. Cette première opération, elle était destinée. Dans cette première opération, on voulait expliquer que les habitants rêvaient d'un quartier reconstruit. Et ils ont donc organisé une inauguration qu'ils ont appelée l'appel du 18 juin. Yes.
That was the one. It's a very French approach, but the whole inauguration or opening of this mosaic was based on a very, very important, because it was on the 18th of June, 1993. 18th of June marks for the French people the call of General de Gaulle from London, calling to the French people to be resistant and to fight the occupation at the time. So it was a wink to General de Gaulle. And it worked really well with the local authorities because they gave them the contract to do many more work after.
C'était un clin d'œil pour débloquer, pour changer l'attitude des politiques.
It was a wink to change the attitude of politicians because Patrick, unfortunately, has to deal with lots of politics and it doesn't seem to be very easy for them.
Et nous leur avons demandé de nous donner davantage de travail, à commencer par davantage de mosaïques dans la reconstruction.
So that was the beginning actually of many more work to come, but they had to convince them, and this mosaic was actually the start of many, many more projects and mosaics that they've done after with the local people and embellishing and changing their local environment. So these are,
là, vous voyez le quartier reconstruit avec des mosaïques qui sont réalisées par les habitants du quartier. Ils ont refait entièrement les entrées. Ils ont fait des mosaïques là où tout à l'heure vous avez vu le quartier ghetto. C'est exactement au même endroit.
So what the picture you saw earlier on, which really looks like a ghetto neighborhood, this is now rebuilt completely with the help of the local people who have been employed. So not only they have They've had a job, they've earned money, but they also participate greatly to embellish their own home. And now this area in Chartres looks what it looks like. It's a very nice area, and things have come down much more quiet, much calmer. I think they have had a great success. So, what would you say about this picture?
About that what picture. nous, elle représente quelque chose que vous connaissez, puisque c'est la chapelle Fulbert et l'intérieur de la chapelle Fulbert. En 1996, nous avons réalisé la première exposition internationale, les premières rencontres internationales.
C'est une belle aventure.
So in 1996, following the social work, which was restoring the work of Raymond Isidore, which was also reviving and restoring the concept of mosaic in Chartres, and also restoring like on a visual way and also social way, local people who have participated and used the mosaic. This is what came out of it. Les rencontres internationales de mosaïque, so the international encounters of mosaic, which is now has become a very prestigious exhibition in Chartres, and it's this is their social work which have finally given this revival also of mosaic.
Nous l'avons créé pour le 10e anniversaire de l'association qui en 1996 avait 10 ans.
So we created it for the 10th anniversary of their association.
À l'époque, Christiane et moi-même, nous avons rencontré deux personnages importants et influents.
So at the time, we met two very important and affluent people, such as
Paul Fuchs, qui est un psychanalyste qui a écrit sur la maison Picassière.
So Paul Fuchs, who is a psychanalyst. Oui. And who wrote a lot about the Picassiet House.
Et Giovanna Galli.
And Giovanna Galli.
Qui est une grande mosaïste que vous connaissez tous.
National mosaic artist.
Et tous les deux, pour notre anniversaire, nous ont dit, mais c'est une très bonne idée.
So together, they agreed that it was a great idea.
De faire une exposition.
To have an exhibition.
Ils nous ont proposé de faire des conférences.
They also offered to give lots of conferences. About the subject of mosaic. Oui.
Nous voulions créer le prix Raymond Isidore.
And we wanted to create the Raymond Isidore, also named Picassiet.
Et finalement, Paul Fuchs nous a dit non, il faut faire crâne, il faut l'appeler le prix Picassiet.
And on the advice of Fuchs, they said. No, you should call it the Picasso Award Prize. Yes. And it became this international event.
Et maintenant, nous recevons tous les deux ans 10 000 visiteurs à peu près.
So it's a two-year event, and they receive around 10,000 visitors. But as we speak, the exhibition, the event started last week, last Saturday, and a lot of us were there last weekend.
Aujourd'hui, on veut montrer aussi que on a voulu montrer quelques années après les rencontres que l'œuvre d'Isidore s'était poursuivie et donc on a créé un chemin qu'on appelle le chemin Picassiet et qui est formé de 15 mégalithes couverts de mosaïques. Et qu'on peut voir en quittant la mosaïque, en quittant la maison Picassiet. Donc en quittant la maison Picassiet, on peut se rendre compte que le travail a continué.
So in order to show how the work of Isidore had such a resonance over our social action over that particular neighborhood, we decided to create a sort of megalithic path partially covered of mosaics. And these blocks of stones are made of pink sandstones that comes from Cap Frère, so they had to go all the way to Brittany in France to get these very rare rocks, and they have created a path from the Picassiet House all around the area just to mark his work and just to never forget about it.
Voilà, maintenant, les visiteurs de la maison Picassiette peuvent, en quittant la maison Picassiette, découvrir tout le travail qui a été fait en son nom sur ce quartier.
So all the visitors coming out after the visit to the Picassiette house can also now visit and follow the path of all the work which has been done by the association on behalf of just to remember the work of this man which has influenced so many other beautiful things.
L'association a voulu continuer de communiquer et donc c'est une histoire qui n'a jamais cessé d'évoluer. En 2003, la ville de Chartres nous a confié la gestion de la chapelle Saint-Aimant.
So after this prestigious event, etc., etc., the city of Chartres started to think that maybe there's something about it, about mosaic, and maybe we should do a little bit of effort, and they get the association, the control, the management of a beautiful chapel called Chapelle Saint-Aimant, where they regularly receive international mosaic artists. Here you can see a mosaic of Marco de Luca
himself.
I can't recognize him. This is the front of the.
Oui, of, the front of.
Do you have any other picture of this of Saint-Aimant? No.
Inside Saint-Aimant? No. Sorry.
But anyway, you this year you've had Felice Nitolo.
Mm. Oui.
And next year you will have.
Next year we have. Toyohiki, on va continuer aussi avec Inès Morigi-Berti.
They're going to carry on with Inès Morigi-Berti.
Nous voulons aussi réaliser un hommage à Ali Kata, qui est décédé il y a quelques mois à Venise, et probablement ses élèves vont être encouragés à faire quelque chose.
Ali Kata, who's died this year.
Oui.
You're going to have another. You're going to have an exhibition dedicated to her life.
Avec ses élèves.
And her students.
Oui.
Okay.
Une façon de revenir peut-être
au début
puisque ce sont les élèves de l'ICATA, je parlais tout à l'heure de Giovanna Galli, ce sont les élèves de l'ICATA qui nous ont beaucoup encouragés à faire ce qu'on a fait.
And it's a wink as well to the beginning of our adventure because the students of l'ICATA were the ones at the beginning who helped us strongly helped us to start this adventure with Les Rencontres and
So
we have to
on a presque terminé. Une dernière image
image
qui vous montre une mosaïque qui vient d'un immeuble qui a été cassé. On refait la mosaïque, on la répare, mais elle est faite dans un immeuble. Vous voyez les côtés en parpaing.
Okay, so that was on the wall of one of the buildings.
On a découpé la façade.
You had to cut it entirely and restore it. Just
voilà.
Like a few images
voilà
now
quelques...
of the mosaic studio, wood studio.
Espace vert.
Ouais. So this is all the type of work they're doing, like the landscape, cleaning, fixing.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.